Okay, so we are halfway there with hiding our categories. So just a quick recap, we got access to our screen viewport handle using the onViewOpen event on the view manager, and this gives us access to our viewport. And on this, we call the method changeCategoryDisplay that allows us to hide categories, which is what we're trying to do. But what it needs is the IDs of the categories that we want to hide. And all we have are these category names that we came up with in our discovery process in the beginning. So how do we get from these names to actual category IDs? We head on over to our good old friend, the iModel console. Now the iModel console gives us the ability to explore our iModel data, which we talked about. And the first step of that process is to head on over to the iModel Schema Explorer. And we're gonna look up the class that we're searching for. So we are looking for a category. So let's take a quick look at the biz description of this. It says that biz.category categorizes geometric elements, and there's only one and only one category per geometric element, so it has a one-to-one relationship. And we have the ability to turn on and off categories, the visibility of the categories, for each view that we're controlling. So that's exactly what we're trying to do. So let's go ahead and search for all our categories within this iModel. So I'll do a select star from the schema.class name, which is bizcore.category, press enter, and that gives us a list of all the categories within this iModel. Now, if you scroll to the right, we can start looking for our name property. So code value is where the names are under. Now, these are the names that we saw when we were making a list of the categories we want to turn off, and these match up to our list over here. So from this point, the question is, how do we get our IDs? So the IDs for the categories are the ECSense ID. As I talked about, that's the ID used for uniquely identifying any element within the iModel, which includes categories. So we need to get the list of the ECSense IDs for the elements, the categories that have the code value equal to our list in our notepad. So how do we do that? Let's do a select star from biz.category, which is what we did. We don't need the star. All we need here is the ECSense ID. And then from biz.category, and then we can do a where clause, where our code value in, and then we can pass in an array. This is just basic SQL. We can pass in an array of tags. So let's do a couple right now. We'll do these four. Let's go with that. Paste this in, and they need to be strings, of course. So let me add that and add our commas here. And I press enter, and that gives us the ECSense IDs for these categories. Now we'll take the statement and we will start modifying it within our code. Okay, so let's create a new variable to hold our query. Let's call a query, and let's make a template string and paste it in. And this is a long statement, so we'll clean it up, separate out this where clause into the next line. And then we don't have to explicitly type out all our categories. I think that's a little too much. Let's instead pass in a variable so it's cleaner. And we'll call it categories to hide. And let's declare it over here. Categories to hide, and it'll be a string array. And to start with, let's just make it empty. And then we'll need to copy out our list of categories to hide from here. Let's copy that over and paste it. And oh no, that's a mess. So what do we need here? We need to turn them into strings. But keep in mind, we also need to add the quotes within our ECSQL statement in the in clause. So these are strings, and we want to make sure we add that extra quote so ECSQL can understand them within the where clause. All right, at this point, I'm going to clean up the rest of this mess, so give me one moment. Okay, so we have our nice array of categories to hide. And the cool thing about having it set up this way is that if you want to add or remove categories later, it's very easy to do it in this format versus having to go through the statement all over again. Within the statement, we want to make sure we pass this in as a toString because we don't want to pass it in as an array, so it formats it right, and that should give us our final query. Now, how do we actually execute this query? So do you remember our iModel connection handle that I talked about in the beginning? That's where that comes in. This is for querying any data within our iModel. So how do we use this? Now, there is a API within our iModel connection called query that allows us to execute ECSQL queries, and within this, we just pass in our query. And let's store our result within our result variable.
A small correction from the future here. iModel query query should be iModel query query, comma, undefined, comma, brackets row format, query row format, .newsjs property names. The latest version returns an array instead of an object if the row format option parameter is not specified. The second undefined argument is called params. It's an optional argument to bind values to. We don't need to worry about it for this query.
And what's the format of this result? It is a async iterator. So what we can do is we can iterate through our result to get the actual rows of our query result. So let's go ahead and do that. For await, we'll create a row of result. And let's just log the row result for now. You'll see that this await is giving us an issue. That's probably because it needs an async function, and we can just make this async. And in order
let's,
to view the log
hit up
result,
our app
we need
now.
To make sure our code compiles. So let's just fill this bad boy up with some empty values to begin with. Save. Wait for it to load. Console, hello world. And we have our IDs for the categories. Now you'll notice that they're separate objects. What we need is we need to combine them into a single array, which we can pass into our change category display function. So let's go ahead and do that. I'll just create another array here. Let's call it category IDs, and let's make it empty. And what we can do is we can push our row data into this, so row.id. That gives us our categories. Just to make sure, let's log this as well real quick. So we'll do a log on category IDs. Perfect, as we expect, it's an array of EC instance IDs of the categories you want to hide. And now let's just call our change category display method. I'm going to move this down. And let's pass in our category IDs. And the other thing this function needs is a boolean of are we displaying, are we turning these categories on or off? In this case, we're turning them off, so let's set that to false. Hit save, pop open our app again. And here's our view. This is exactly what we expect for our ideal view, the categories that we don't need. The outside of the house is hidden. At this point, we are in a really good place to start building our smart house. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and clean my code up, probably extract it into a separate class, and I'll catch you in the next video.